He got all of that one.
The offense heads out onto the field for the first time. So they have first and 10 here. The home team come out in a nickel package. You'll feel that one tomorrow.
Yeah, with how hard he just got hit, he's lucky to be able to hold on to the ball.
Gain of 4. It's second down and 7 to go. Number 80, the man in motion. Samuel makes the stop at the 29, and he picks up about 4. John, for people who love defensive struggles, this game is exactly what they're looking for. Two of the best in the league out on the field today.
These are two of the most talented defenses in the league. Not only can these guys stop you from scoring,
they can create scoring by themselves.
Yeah, you're right. I wouldn't be surprised if this game turns on a big defensive play that generates points, like an interception return or a fumble recovery, something like that.
A fresh set of downs after a nice pickup on the ground.
Hey, nice job up front, holding their blocks and allowing him to get a good run for a first down.
First and 10. Seymour hauls him down behind the line. His excellent positioning led to that stop behind the line of scrimmage.
And he'll do that kind of thing. He's one of the smartest players at defensive end. He always seems to be in position. He uses his hands well, and he has those long arms. And that really helps him shed blocking.
The home team come out in a nickel package. Gets rid of it. This pass is incomplete. The wobbly pass falls to the ground incomplete.
He hung that one up there, but no one was able to get under it and make the catch.
Sixth play of this drive. Throws it. Incomplete pass. McMahon read it perfectly with single coverage, but the ball was tipped away. Number 8 is ready to punt this one away. Here's the kick. And he chooses not to return this one. They're ready to go on offense for the first time. So they have first and 10 here. Watson in motion. They'll pass on first down. Pressure gets the pass off. And it's caught. John, one of your favorite terms right here. I'm going to use it. Boom.
Yeah, but that's worse than a boom. That kind of hit can loosen your teeth.
Brady is known throughout football for his precision and accuracy, John.
And with good reason. You talk about accuracy, hitting spots and leading receivers, he can do it all. And he makes it look so easy, too. I really like watching him play out there.
Watson, the motion man. Frazier makes the tackle at the 38, so a gain of about 1. Under a yard to go. Throws it. Perfect pass. Marshall with the tackle at the 48. Good-looking play.
Hey, I like to see him get the fullback involved in the passing game. He's a pretty good option out of the backfield. He has quick feet, good hands, so passing to him sometimes is a pretty good idea.
So they have first and 10 here. They'll go from the I formation. Brady with a man in motion. Under pressure with the throw, and he makes the grab. Stallworth didn't have much room to do anything with that ball.
Yeah, they had the coverage, and they made the sure play instead of trying something fancy, like going for the pick.
They have to get the ball inside the 42 to convert. There's a flag on the play.
False start on the offense. Number seven
was flagged for the false start.
False starts are kind of frustrating because they're really easily avoided by just maintaining focus.
They have to get the ball inside the 42 to convert. Brady sends a man in motion. Dropping back. Pressure coming. Gets the pass off. Incomplete. He barely got that one off.
Any way you look at it, an incomplete pass is a heck of a lot better than throwing it to the other guy.
Sixth play of this drive. The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. Flings it to the outside. And he hits his target. Moss will stop just short of the first down marker on that catch. Miller will do his best to get this one inside their five. Here's the punt. Fair catch called for. So they have first and 10 here. Records the stop at the 27-yard line. And that was a gain of 7. They need about 3. The home team come out in a nickel package. He hands it off, fakes the handoff, gets the pass off. The 40. Harrison pulls him down at the 44. Good throw, good catch to move the chains.
You know, as a receiver, all you have to do is get a step, and this guy's going to put the ball on you.
First and 10. Stop behind the line, lost in a couple. You know, Johnny always seems to be in perfect position to make a play.
He's all about effort. His motor's always running at 100%, and he's got the experience to diagnose plays very quickly.
It's second down and a long way to go. Moorhead moves in motion. Big pop that time.
You want someone there to tell you to watch out because he just got decked.
Gain of about a yard. It's third down and 10 to go. The home team come out in a dime package. Steps up, throwing short to his left. Caught by the fullback on the left side.
Number 26.
Doesn't get enough to convert, and that brings up fourth down. Number 8 will come in now to punt it away. Number 83 sets up to run back the punt. Here's the kick. The officials are trying to determine where it went out of bounds. So they have first and 10 here. Moss goes in motion, passing on first down. Guns it over the middle, and it's caught. Looks like he's just shaken up, and we'll get the full report from Jill very shortly. It's second down and one to go. Brady using split backs. Throws it, and the catch is made. The fullback was on the receiving end.
And it's a good option coming out of the backfield. He can do a lot more than just block. He can catch it out of the backfield, carry it, and heck, I've even seen him throw it once or twice.
So they have first and 10 here. Moss, the motion man. And he gets the delayed handle. Number 95 makes the play at the 47. He might have gotten a yard or two.
That guy got knocked around by that defense. He needs a little protection from his linemen.
Second and nine. At the end of the first quarter, it's not enough. New England, zero. Chicago, zero. The teams have switched sides, and we'll start the second quarter. 9 yards to go. The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. With the throw, incomplete pass. Third down, upcoming after the incomplete pass. And this is the fifth play of this drive. The home team line up in a five-receiver set this time. Dropping back, throwing. The defenders got it. The 40. Marshall showed outstanding athletic ability by grabbing that one.
The receiver didn't do a very good job of fighting for that one.
So they have first and 10 here. Couldn't pick up any blocking on that play.
The defense is always very aggressive when defending the run. They're extremely disciplined, and they get off their blocks very quickly. Makes it tough to find openings when you're running the ball.
They have to get the ball inside the 20 to convert. They come out of the nickel. On the ground. Fakes the handle. And he hits his target. He was on the receiving end of that bullet.
Soft hands like that are hard to find. This guy looks like he's a keeper.
They have to get the ball inside the 20 to convert. There he goes. Wilson makes the tackle at the 12-yard line. And that gain will get them a fresh set of downs.
He just exploded towards the marker that time. That was a big-time run.
First and 10. Another run. Bruschi makes the stop at the 10. Pulled down after a minimal gain.
They just manhandled him at the line of scrimmage. I always say that if you win the battle in the trenches, it's going to go a long way towards your winning the game.
They need 10 for the touchdown. Harrison stops him at the 2-yard line. Peyton picks up some tough yards on the ground, and it's enough for a first down. That's his second on this drive. First down and goal to go. Good job knifing in there to bring him down.
He brings a lot of things to the table, but the thing I like the most is how prepared he always is. I mean, he can run and he can tackle, and he watches so much tape that he actually anticipates what the offense is going to run before they call the play.
They come out of the nickel. Peyton is in there for the score. That was an almost perfect run in that type of situation.
The offense has been knocking on the door, and now they just kicked it down.
Butler comes in to attempt the point after. And it's up. And he tacks on the extra point. The Bears are lined up for the kickoff. And he got all of that one. A great kick. From the three. To the 20. Ready now for the first play of the drive. And the defense will be looking for another pick. It's first and 10. Pass play here on first down. Hit and sack. Perry explodes across the line at the snap and then makes his way to the quarterback.
Yeah, you know, that's an important quality to have if you're going to excel as a pass rusher. Explosiveness.
Now they're looking at second and long after the sack. Number 39, the deep man. Throwing. Perfect pass. Wilson pulls him down at the 26-yard line. Brady, great athlete, and throws one of the prettiest balls in the NFL.
Yeah, receivers love playing with him because he'll never hang you out to dry. That's something he's always had. Good rotation and a soft touch.
Third and 5 coming up. Fall lines up behind his fullback in the eye. He was really hit hard on that play.
Yeah, you talk about your decleaner. That's what happened there. He unloaded, and he got a depleter.
Unable to get anything going on that series, they'll have to punt it away here. Here's the punt. From the 34-yard line. Scored a touchdown on their last drive, utilizing the running game to move the ball against this defense. And we'll probably see the same kind of thing here as they take over again. It's first and 10. Handed off to the back. And he just got level.
Yeah, you know that whole deal about what happens when an unstoppable force meets an immovable object? Well, the unstoppable force won that one.
About 8 yards.
In and out, come on! Set.
They give it to the halfback. Hey, wasn't able to get anything going on that play.
They got there and shut that play down very quickly. That's just a case of studying game film this week paying off. When you know what they like to run in certain situations, you can anticipate the play call and stop the play before it even gets started.
The home team come out with one linebacker and several defensive backs. Dropping back, throwing, and he hits his target. Ball caught it short of the first down marker. Now here's the punt unit as the defense forces a three and out. Here's the kick. Fair catch.
I think the coach needs to look at how his team has done so far and decide if they can put a drive together with this much time left. If he doesn't think they can, or just doesn't want to risk anything, we'll probably see a few runs here.
The home team line up in trips bunch. McMichael takes him down at the 16. And they went with a run on that play.
Yeah, sure looks like this guy's going to be involved in the offense today.
The coach clearly wants him to protect the ball here.
And that's because the defense wants to strip the ball. So if he's trying to stiff arm one guy and then another guy comes over and swipes at it, there's a good chance it'll pop out. But let me tell you, you don't want to turn it over right here and give him an easy chance at getting points before halftime.
Toss play to the right, number 39. Chicago calls a timeout. They have two timeouts remaining. Big tackle there for Lawson. Great pursuit there, John.
You can say that again. He knows how to prepare, and it really pays off when you make stops like that.
Just over a minute still to go. Off to the tailback. Anthony breaks the play up in the backfield, and he chases him down behind the line of scrimmage for a loss.
I'll tell you, he's one of the most knowledgeable defenders in the league. He knows how to play the game, and he always knows what's going on.
Time for a punt here as it's now fourth down. Offense couldn't get it done in the lineup to punt. Here's the punt. From midfield. First and 10. The home team come out on a nickel package. McMahon with a man in motion. Dropping back to pass on first down. This pass is incomplete. Good play there to knock it down at the line.
What happened there was they got in the throwing lane. When you're rushing the quarterback, you're taught if you don't get to him in time, get your hands up and try and knock it down just like that.
Just over a minute still to go. Drops back, gets the pass off, breaking free. You can hear the collision up here.
He's feeling it right now. Either that or he's numb all over, and that's worse.
Good-looking play there as they pick up the first down and keep the drive alive. So they have first and 10 here. Nickelback in this time. Setting up play action. Warren brings him down at the 31-yard line. Brought it down and ran with it, but couldn't find any room.
That's a good play by the defensive unit. They let the play develop, and they were right there to bring him down when he decided to run.
They have to get to the 23 to convert for the first. McMahon sends a man in motion. We'll get the call again. Fakes the handoff. Getting some air under this one. Looking for his man deep. Oh, he's in there for the score. And he's able to get open in the end zone. Great play.
The defense just seemed to lose track of him down there. They have to do a better job keeping the play in front of him so that that kind of thing doesn't happen.
Butler comes in for the extra point. The kick is up, and the extra point is good. They've now scored 14 unanswered points.
This is one of those teams that's never out of a game. If you let them get going early, they can really control the tempo of the game. If they fall behind, they have the weapons on the offensive side to put points on the board very quickly.
The Bears are set to kick it deep. Squib kick short. Booming kick right out of the end zone. They forced a three and out on the last series.
They need a big play here if they want to have any shot at scoring before the half.
So they have first and 10 here. They line up in the I formation. Watson, the motion man. give it to the halfback. Number 22 brings him down at the 22. That run didn't get them much.
Yeah, there was a defender in every gap ready to make the tackle on that play.
About 8 yards. Going into halftime, the score is 14-0. We're ready to start the second half of play. And we're set for the second half. Booming kick downfield. Downing the kick might have been the better option, John.
You can't really fault the returner for trying to make a play for his team. He just needs to be a little more patient while making some better decisions when he decides to bring the ball out.
It's first and 10. Number 39, the deep back, closing in. Incomplete. He went down very hard after getting that pass away.
This defense really likes to keep the pressure on the passer. They bull rush, they speed rush, they blitz from the outside, all in an attempt to create turnover opportunities in the secondary. The offensive line needs to do a better job of holding on their block, giving a little extra time in the pocket that the quarterback needs.
And the catch is made. Big hit on the ball carrier.
And when you talk about getting unloaded on, that's what happened here. He just got unloaded on.
Jill, what do you have?
Well, Al, the head coach expects to see plenty of passes here in the second half. And he told his team that the pressure is going to be on the secondary to make plays. With his defense playing so well in the first half, he feels they can continue to make plays for the remainder of the game. Al?
Thanks for that report, Jill. He hits his receiver.
Now, this is one heck of a play. Look at it. You're in a hole here on third down, and they come through with this perfect play that gets them a first and keeps the drive going.
Brady with a man in motion. Passing on first down with the pass, and he makes the grab. Moss brings in his third pass. And this is the fifth play of this drive. So they need about three here. Pressure, rowing. Perfect throw. Marshall pulls him down at the 48. Can't draw it up any better than that. Textbook first down. The ball is right at midfield. Only one man back. Brady sends a man in motion. Throwing on first down. Throws it. He has room. The 40. Number 45 records the stop at the 31-yard line. Great run after the catch by Moss.
Hey, that's all you have to do with this guy. Just give him the ball and let him outrun everybody on the field.
First and 10. They'll go from the I formation. They'll pass on first down. On the run. Drops the interception. Wilson was lurking in the middle and almost had the interception.
I think he was invisible out there. Wasn't even seen. That's a break for the offense.
And this is the eighth play of this drive. With the pass, he hits his receiver. Looks to be all right, though. He'll come out at least for a play or two. And Jill will fill us in a moment. is the ninth play of this drive.
Inside enemy territory.
Gets the toss to the right. Hand it off.
Number 39.
Couldn't find any room on that one.
They really hustle on the defensive side of the ball. They're very good at clogging up the line, limiting the number of holes and cutback lanes that the back has to choose from.
Gramatica lines up for the field goal to try to put them on the board for the first time in the game. And it's on its way. Veteran kicks it through.
No problem for him. Whatever the situation, he'll approach it the same way. Cool and smooth.
The home team are ready to kick this one off.
He's got all of that one.
From the 4-yard line to the 20.
The most important thing to do now is to protect the football. You've got a good lead, and you don't want to throw it away by making any costly mistakes.
It's first and 10. Despite very little success running on first down, they still lead.
And running is important, but they've got other weapons that can get them in the end zone.
Couldn't find much of a hole, and he's brought down after a gain of what looks like a couple.
Yeah, you talk about push. This line got no push at all, and there was nowhere to go.
Second and 7 coming up here.
Strong right, strong right. Mike, cover, Mike.
Nickelback in this time. Hand it off. Play action. Dropped in the backfield for a short loss. Seymour drags him down behind the line. Great play from the defensive end.
He's such a disruptive force against the pass, whether he's coming after the quarterback or knocking the ball out of the air.
9 yards to go. The home team come out in a dime package. Drops back, looking for a receiver, gets the pass off. He finds his man. Number 27 makes the tackle at the 43-yard line. We'll get to Jill in a second to find out about the injury. So they have first and 10 here. They can't get it done on the ground on first down, John, but they're still leading in this one.
Some teams manage to get by pretty well without a solid running game. And that's mostly because their passing game is very effective, especially their short passing game.
They're going to keep testing this rushing defense.
The guy seems to get stronger every time he touches the ball.
They need about 3. McMahon sends a man in motion. Gets the call. Fakes the handoff with the throw, and it's intercepted. The offensive line couldn't do the job, and the pressure forced him to make a bad throw into coverage.
I'll tell you, it's very important to have pressure on the quarterback. What that does is make the secondary job a heck of a lot easier. And on that play, it led to an interception.
So after the interception now, it's first and 10. Play to the left, dropped in the backfield for a short loss. So after that run, we can see how the two main threats on the ground have fared so far. It's second down and a long way to go. Number 39, the lone back. Dropping back, under pressure, gets the pass off with the hurdle.
Here's an opening.
The 30, the 20. Diving tackle at the 14-yard line. He brings it in for a big game.
Almost every wide receiver gets better at running routes as they get older. And this guy's no exception.
They're in field goal range.
Ooh, ooh.
Here we are in the third quarter. This is the first time they've been inside the 20-yard line. Soft lob to the end zone. Incomplete pass. Looking for the touchdown on first down, but couldn't get it to his target. They line up in the I formation. Again on the run. Dives and brings him down. Not much on that play.
Yeah, and that's what happens when you talk about a disciplined defense. They stay at home and wait for the runner to come to them.
In field goal range now. Brady will work out of the shotgun. Gets rid of it. And he fails to hang on to that one. Moss dropped the ball, and if he's dropping passes, who's the quarterback going to go to next?
One drop doesn't mean that you should stop going to him. If you have a guy that you're comfortable with, you got to go to him. Even guys like Terrell Owens will drop one every now and then.
Martin Gramatica comes in for about a 30-yard field goal attempt. And it's up. He made that one easily. The home team are now down by only a touchdown. The home team are lined up for the kickoff. Not a bad kick. They'll set up for the return. From the 11. Chicago is looking to build its lead with this drive. First and 10. Makes the stop at the 30-yard line. And now our viewers can see how successful each team's main running threat has been today. About 8 yards.
Okay, here we go.
Number 80 comes in motion. Dropped in the backfield for a short loss. They couldn't escape the pursuit and was cut down quickly.
These guys up front are very tough to block because they can use their size and strength to get excellent leverage on running play. Sometimes they struggle a little with their consistency, but they always seem to be a big factor when the game's on the line.
The home team come out with 3 down linemen and 7 defensive backs. They completed 3 quarters of play and the score is 14-6. The Bears have the lead and are in control as we begin the final quarter. It's 3rd down and 10 to go. The home team come out in a dime package. Dropping back, slings it to the outside. Bruschi stops him for negative yardage.
Number 26.
Can't get past the marker, so it'll bring up 4th down. Unable to get anything going on that series, they'll have to punt it away here. Here's the kick. From the 36, it's on the ground. And the fumble goes out of bounds. It's 1st and 10. The home team line up in a 5-receiver set this time. Stallworth makes the catch but doesn't get very far.
And that's what the mark of a solid defense is. They close in on you in a hurry and they don't miss tackle.
2nd and long coming up here. coming. This one falls incomplete. That throw just a bit off target.
Yeah, he threw it where the receiver used to be, not where he was going.
Brady will work out of the shotgun. Dropping back. Throws on the move. Completed pass to the wide receiver.
Stalwart
gets stopped short of the sticks on that play. Miller will come into this game to punt. Here's the punt. And he waves for the fair catch. First and 10. Just unloaded on him.
Boom. Now that is what football's all about.
Gain of about a yard. And they need about 9. Hand it off to the back. The 30. Samuel takes him down at the 36-yard line.
Take a look at this. He gets himself into position, keeps his legs under him, and then boom, he just unloads. Now that's a depleter.
With the tackle at the 46-yard line. Payton got the carry there and is now closing in on 100 yards rushing. So they have first and 10 here. Very good penetration there. They may want to dump that play, John.
Yeah, that's what this defense will do to you. They're so good in pursuit that if you start trying to go east and west in the backfield, you're in trouble. I'd try and run the ball right at them. That'll negate the speed that these guys have to the outside.
Moorhead comes in motion. Rock behind the line for a loss of a couple. Looks like he's just shaken up, and we'll get the full report from Jill very shortly. They'll be faced with a long third down play here. A lot of speed on the field for the defense as they line up in the quarter. With the throw, right to him. And he's forced out of bounds at the 43.
Watch it here. This is a great call on third down to keep this drive alive. They were in a tough spot here, but this is a heck of a throw and catch to pick up that first down.
Once again, ooh, that one will leave a mark.
He got hit so hard he darn near had to take a taxi back to the stadium.
Short gain on that burst through the middle, maybe half a yard.
I don't think I'd call that run a burst. That was more of a limp up the middle.
Second and 8 coming up here. Hand it off to the back. In the backfield for a short loss. Hey, couldn't find an opening and was brought down very quickly.
Yeah, he was. This line has to do a better job of holding up at the point of attack. He has a fast first step. He can explode through the hole. But he needs a line to create that little crease or cutback lane to break free. The offense has been stepping it up on third down all day.
Big hit there. He was run over by a truck.
Yeah, two-ton truck pulling a trailer.
And he's now closer to 100 yards rushing. He'll try to place this inside the 10. Here's the punt. And this one comes back out to the 20. Inside their own 5. Only one man back. Dropping back to pass on first down. With the throw. Incomplete pass. Time is working against them.
Yeah, I'm thinking they're going to keep going to the air, but it might be a little too late.
On second down, they figure to go to the air as they try to get closer to the end zone. The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. Throwing. And he hits his target. Dante Stallworth. He stopped cold after making the reception, so they're looking at third down. They want to hurry it up here. With the pass, and it's intercepted. The 10, room to run. Touchdown, Chicago. A spectacular interception and return for a touchdown. They'll get set for the extra point. The kick is up. The extra point attempt is good. The Bears are taking control in this one. The Bears are set to kick it deep. And he got all of that one, a great kick. Last time the offense had the ball, they gave it away on an interception. Let's see what happens this time down the field.
First down may be where they try something towards the end zone, since they'll have three more downs to work with after that.
It's first and 10. The quarterback is back in the shotgun. Gets rid of it. Incomplete pass. He knew that one was a catch if he didn't hit him hard.
Yeah, so good it knocked the ball right out of his hand. They're going to make the quarterback keep throwing because it's the only way that they have a shot at coming back.
The quarterback gets set with only one back behind him. Closing in, off-balance throw. He hits his receiver. Good job getting it in there, John. Looks like he threw off his back foot.
And he didn't have the time that he was hoping for, and he had to buy a little more. He took off, ran around a little bit, let this guy come free, and he makes a pretty good pass for a first down.
Pressure, guns it to the right side. The 40, big pop that time.
Boom, now that is big time football.
Ball on their own 42. And this is the fifth play of this drive. A little over a minute left. The home team line up with two backs behind the quarterback.
Throwing. He finds his man. Richardson with the stop at the 48.
Changing the play now.
Passing on first down.
Throws it. This one falls incomplete.
No choice here, John. They just have to keep throwing.
Yeah, they do. Running the ball isn't going to do a whole lot of good now.
They have to move him down quickly here on second down.
And this is the seventh play of this drive.
Okay, here we go.
Only one man back. With the pass, he hits his receiver.
To get the ball inside the 42 to convert.
Only one man in the backfield. Throws it, and it's caught.
They'll pass on every play from here on out.
When you're down by more than one score and there's less than a minute left, that's all you can really do.
First and 10.
Pass on first down. Gets the pass off, and he fails to hang on to that one. No catch. The receiver had it slip out of his hands.
Okay, they got to keep throwing downfield to move the chain while keeping the clock movement to a minimum.
10th play of this drive. They line up in the I formation. With the pass.
Incomplete pass. Brady was under intense pressure.
The play didn't work because the quarterback's timing and balance was off. When he starts to feel pressure, he gets a little nervous, and he has to get rid of the ball.
11th play of this drive. Only one man back.
Throws out to the left.
With the adjustment.
To move the sticks with that completion.
I tell you, he put that one right on the money. They're just out there playing a little pitch and catch.
He's calling everyone up to the line of scrimmage. Spike stops the clock.
Second down, goal to go.
The quarterback lines up with two backs behind him. Throws to the end zone.
This one falls incomplete.
And this is an incredible play by the defender. No, he didn't look like he would be there in time. But he jumped over the top of everyone, and he got his hand on it to knock it away. They're running out of time and downs. It's time for them to call their best play before it's too late.
Here's a look at the third down success rate of each team.
Third down conversions are usually a good barometer of how well your offense is playing. It means your offense is making big plays when they need them.
Dropping back. Looks to the end zone.
This is just a beautiful play to force the incompletion. I mean, he gets up high, and he turns what could be a touchdown into a heck of a defensive play.
Pressure, throwing a strike to the end zone. New England had to get it into the end zone, but can't get there, and John, that may do it.
That's one of the most disappointing things that a coach could watch. You're inside the 10, you need a touchdown, you call good plays, and the defense stops you short.
They'll come out running here to wind the clock down. Hand off to the tailback. Wilson stops him at the 11-yard line. Penalty marker down. The home team call a timeout. That's their final timeout. They pulled the defense offside and got the first down.
And here is a situation where you can't lose. The defense gets pulled offsides, which basically gives you a free play. Even if you miss, you still get the first down.
Hand it off.
John, the coaches are always talking about his intensity and awareness.
And those are the type of plays where you see those qualities really showing himself. He's a cornerstone of this defense. And he always seems to be in the right position to make the play.
So this could be the last play of the game. And the clock runs out. The final score is Chicago 21, New England 6. Not much of a contest, as the point differential is 2 touchdowns.